Hello students, my name is Hardevinder. Today we will discuss this computer applications topic, managing files and folders. This is a third lesson of class 5. So let us start. Students, you know it's very important to manage the things. If you are sitting at your home, in your shop, whether these are your books or any other home appliance like your dresses, your socks, everything. If you have managed the things in a proper way, it's a very easy for you to find out the things. If you are not managing the things well, it will be a very much difficult for you to find out. It will be a very much difficult for you to locate the things when you need them in emergency. Suppose you visit to a medical store. You want a medicine. You see, there are a lot of in lakhs they are having the medicines. But when they see your slip and they find out within minutes, how? Because they have managed all their medicines in a proper order. They have managed in a proper way. That's why they can easily find out the medicine which you require. So managing the things in a proper way is a very much important in your life. How to manage the things in a computer so that if you want your file and folder, you can easily locate them. In this chapter, we will learn about them. So how to manage the things? Well, in this chapter, we are going to learn Windows Explorer, creating and operating a folder, moving or copying file folder, deleting a file folder, restoring a file folder, searching a file folder, working with multiple applications, sorting files. So let us start. First, Windows Explorer. Windows Explorer means it can be a, I'm telling you, when we are talking about these managing files and folders, we are not just talking about computer only. We are talking on all electronic devices, whether this is your laptop, computer, your mobile device, your tablet, everywhere these things in the same way you can learn, whether that is a Windows operating system, any other operating system like Android, Mac, Ubuntu, Linux, in any operating system the same things you can apply or similar to, but maximum in this chapter as your syllabus we are talking about the Windows. There are many other operating systems like Windows, Android and Linux, etc. Windows Explorer is an application that provides a detailed information about the files, folders and drives, offers you to manage and organize your files and folders. You can use it to view, create, delete, copy, move, rename and search files and folders. So this is a Windows Explorer. What is students, I am telling you in the right now, I'm not using a Windows operating system, I'm using a Linux operating system. So things are same, you know, whether you are using Windows or any other operating system. So in this Linux operating system, this is like a Windows Explorer. Here you can see in the right hand side, you can see recent means the recent files which you have opened. You want to see, these are the files which I recently opened, means fresh files, just a few minutes ago or just few minutes ago I have used these files. I want to use them frequently. Again and again, we have to find out the files. You can see in the rename home, it shows all folders, system folders. System means inbuilt folders. When you install operating system, your device, these are the pre-built, means you have not created these folders. Inbuilt folders are these, like desktop, documents, desktop. The desktop, you know very well, the very first screen which when you switch on your computer, the very first thing is a desktop. You keep some files on desktop which you need frequently, maximum. So means you keep the things on your table which you need frequently, like your pen, razor, etc. Similarly on a desktop computer, desktop you can keep the things which you need. Documents folder, this is to keep your, store your documents, downloads, whenever you download anything from internet, these all files go in this downloads folder. Music related files, songs, etc., all automatically you can save in this music folder, or some built-in music is also available in this. Some your pictures, public, snap, templates, videos, means for different things you can use the different folders. This is not a thing, everything you are keeping in a single folder, it will be a very much difficult for you to find out if everything you are keeping in a single Almira. If you are having a Almira, you have divided that Almira in different parts. In this part, I'll keep my books, in this I'll keep my gadgets, and in this part, in this column, I will keep my socks. In the same way, in a computer, you can create different folders for keeping the different things, so that you can easily locate the things whenever you require. So this is a very important. So this is a Windows Explorer, where you can keep all your you can see your all your inbuilt folders, which and next is creating and opening folder. You know very well, if you want to create your own folder, means there are the folders which we have seen in the previous screen, those were the built-in folders, built-in operating system folders. If you want to create your own folder, so how to create, you very know very well. When you open this C drive or D drive, whatever in Windows, there is a icon, new folder, you can click there, and then new and folder, you can click here, and you can rename the folder. Moving or copying a file folder from one drive to another. What are the drives? All the things which we keep in our electronic device, whether that is a computer, laptop or tablet, those are kept in the drives. Drives means a storage device. So these storage devices are further divided into C drive, D drive, system files, like this. If you want to copy your file from one location to another location, suppose you want to copy your file from C drive to D drive, or you want to copy your file from computer to your flash drive, means pen drive, you want to copy your file from computer to your mobile device, you can attach your device with your computer, and you want to copy the file from your computer to your mobile. How to do that thing, that we will learn in this module. Or you can copy your file in a cloud computing, means on internet, or the from where the location, from where you are picking the file, that is called a source, and the where you are keeping your file, that is a destination. I'm giving you an example. Suppose you are taking out a book from your bag. Your bag is a source, and you are keeping your that book on your table. The table is a destination. From where you are copying, that is a source, and where you are keeping, that is called a destination. So copying a folder means deleting. Sometimes we don't need the files more. You think this is occupying my space unnecessarily, I don't need these files again, and I want to delete them, or you have taken their backups, you have kept these your important files on internet or any other drive, or in flash drive, and you have copied in a CD or somewhere. You don't require the more these files on your computer, on your device, which is occupying space unnecessarily. So you want to delete them, so you can delete automatically. You can just select the file and press the delete button, that will go in a trash, or you can say recycle bin. Recycle bin means if you think it has been deleted by a mistake, you can restore the things from a recycle bin. I'll show you in this. Here is a, I'm using a Linux, here is a trash. Suppose I'll delete this folder, right click, and there is an option, there is no option. Suppose I press just delete key, that has gone in a trash. I thought that was a very important folder, I by mistake I have deleted, I want to restore it. Don't worry, you can just click here, and empty trash means you can restore from here. Just you can get it back. You can get it back from here. Yes friends, you can click this folder, and this is a folder which I have by mistake I have deleted, I want to get it back. So I can click here and restore from trash. It will come back on that same desktop from where I had deleted. The recycle bin in Windows, this Linux, there is a name, is a trash, or different names for different devices. So by mistake, anything, any folder, any file you have deleted, you can locate that thing from a trash. So this is a use of trash. So we were talking about this deleting files and folders. Now searching and files and folders. Sometimes you forgot where you have saved your file. Every operating system provides us a search box from where you can easily search your files. Suppose I forgot where I have kept my this. Suppose I have to locate any folder file. This related videos, where I have kept the videos. In this search box, I can search these videos and these. In search box, computer can, any operating system having a search box through which you can search the things. It's a very intelligent search box. It can save your time easily. Suppose you have lost something in your home, it will be a very much difficult for to search it. If that is not easy to locate. But in computer, that's not a much tough. You can just use the search box. Now searching files using wildcard. Wildcard are the special symbols for searching the things. Suppose I have to locate a file, but I don't remember the name, exactly the name of that file, but I remember few words. I know that is a PDF. That file's extension is PDF, so I can write *.pdf. Star means any file which having the last three digits as a PDF. So the number of wildcard or special symbols that can be used to search the file and pose whose exact name you don't know. There are two wildcard characters, star and question mark, commonly supported in Windows to search information. In wildcard character, star can be used to replace the string or of text in a search term, a string of text or any other or character. Suppose this L star dot star will search all files whose name start with L followed by any number of characters and have any extension. Suppose I have written the first character is L, then number of characters, any number of characters or any characters, then dot, and after that again there can be any characters. It will search all files which are starting with L. Similarly, the next example I have shown, *.docx, it will show all the files whose are ending with docx, .docx. The beginning, in the starting, the number of characters can be any. Similarly, next *.docx, starting with L and ending with docx, in between there may be a number of characters or any characters. Similarly, this next wildcard is a question mark. Suppose this wildcard character question mark can be used to place any single letter or a symbol. Suppose I want to search Kips and there is a one character after that Kips, which that character I don't know. It will search all the files Kips which are starting with Kips and a single character. That character can be any. .docx will search for all the files whose name begin with the Kips and followed by any character and extension as a docx. For example, Kips1.docx and so on. Similarly, next Kips question mark question mark question mark means Kips, and there are three followed by three characters that can be any. Suppose Kips .docx means there should be a three characters after Kips, and those characters can be any. So question mark is used for a single character and a star is used for a number of characters. Wildcard search. So sorting, sometimes you need to sort the things. Sort means arranging the things in ascending or descending order. Suppose you have a number of files in your folder and you want to arrange them in a date wise, means the file which you created very last, very first, that should be on a top, then second and third, and suppose you want to arrange them in a descending order. The latest file which you have just created, that should be on a top. So you can sort the things in ascending or descending order so that you can easily locate them. So sorting desktop items means arranging them in a proper order. Windows lets you to sort the files by name, size, items. You can sort the things by names means in alphabetic order, by size. The bulky files should be on top, or small files, small size files on top, or by date, anything in any order you can arrange them. So there is an option in Windows Explorer. You can see the sorting option is available. I'll show you in this Linux. So this is a organized way in this you can sort the things. So files alphabetic order, it's showing in alphabetic order. Suppose I want to show in a date wise, so I'll click here, it will show on the day and time wise. So this very fast, just I use this today at 7:19 a.m. and this was yesterday, then Friday, and this date wise. Or you can use them in alphabetic order. So in or size wise, the very small files are on top, and these are sorting means arranging the files in ascending or descending order. So now working with multiple applications, you can open multiple applications, multiple windows at a time. Suppose I want to use this file and this files together. I want to see something from here, I want to write here. So I can use these two windows together, I can open them. This way, or three, or this also I want to open. So this also you can open. And number of files and folders, number of windows you can open at a single time. So this is working with multiple files. So we were discussing sorting, working with multiple applications. Thank you, students. I hope you have learned well. So study this presentation again and study your chapter also. Next time we will discuss the questions. I'll ask some questions regarding this chapter. Thank you. Thank you very much, friends.